sorry, but my doctor said I cannot hit it from the back for 6 to 8 weeks.
That is not how you start this, because I didn't ask.
I'm just telling you.
No, wait. You asked, did you specifically go in the doctor and say, yo, can I hit it from the back?
Yeah. And she was like, well, what leg do you use for leverage? And I was like, my right. And she was like, well, it doesn't seem like you're going to have that for, you know, 6 to 8 weeks. So I surmised that I can't hit it from the back for 6 to 8 weeks. My mama was in there, too. She was kind of taken aback when I asked her that question.
Oh, my God.
Yeah.
Well, I mean, that's fine.
I don't like the way you just brushed it off like it wasn't going to be the end of your life.
I think that's a little dramatic.
You don't want to give me no dramatics?
No, I'm not. I mean, that's fine.
I think my penis give you dramatics.
What do you think dramatics are?
You know, like, oh my God, for real?
Have I ever grabbed my chest like that?
I clutch my pearls. You're
did
right.
You? Have I ever done that?
Nah, but I would expect that when I tell you I can't hit it from the back. Because that's like your favorite position.
That is my favorite position.
Exactly.
I'm sure we can prop you up some kind of way to make it work.
The fuck do I look like? Prop me up.
Like, you know, like they do. Weekend at Bernie's, he always looked alive. We could do something where you got cushion and you could.
No, I am not.
What if you, if we're at the edge of the bed and then
I
you
have to stand.
No, you don't. Like, if you dangle your feet off the edge of the bed, but
I'm
you're
not
still on your knees.
It, dangling my feet like a little school
should
kid.
Should I not have said dangle?
That was the word.
Okay, if your feet are off of the bed a little bit, but
dangling.
Your knees are still up there.
Only thing that's in my mind is dangling.
But you're not pressing your foot on anything, so it's just hanging. And then you're still hitting it.
So my knees.
Yeah.
My knees are bad.
They're not that bad.
Mm.
No, I think you can still do it. I think you don't believe in yourself. Honestly.
I think you don't believe in my pain.
No, that's what I said. You don't have to...
Knees.
But your knees are not what's wrong with you.
Not today.
It's the foot.
The foot.
Okay. Oh. It's all right.
Man.
It's okay. Let's talk about these shorts that you had on before we started recording.
We don't have to talk about the shorts because I took them off because you and the rest of the people on Instagram Live are fucking bullies.
All right. He had okay? on some... Golden
last time I checked
shorts.
Last time I checked, bullying is something that we don't take in 2023.
No, we should never take bullying. Actually, I got some shit on bullying. Oh.
What?
I feel like my daughter's getting bullied right now. Or our daughter.
What do we call bullying and what do we call kids being assholes? Because I think that there is a fine line, especially in today's climate of life and how kids are sensitive and going through everything. And I think there's a fine line between kids just being assholes the way they are and actually bullying, like specifically picking someone and saying, I'm going to antagonize them at every chance I get.
I think the problem is they don't know how to distinguish what it is because I think they got the word bullying and everything is bullying.
Right. Like my yellow shorts, y'all saw it and y'all attacked me and you kept attacking me until
like,
I changed them.
Felt like that was bullying?
That was bullying.
No, I was being an asshole. That was me just genuinely being an asshole. Like,
but no, like I don't think that she's being bullied. I think that she's just around a bunch of assholes.
Yeah. Okay.
Honestly. All right. I think if it was bullying, there would be much more of a visceral reaction from her.
Come on, say that again. Say visceral.
Because I don't know how to spell it.
Oh, I do.
How you spell visceral?
I think it's V-I-S-C-E-R-A-L. What are you talking about?
It's not how you spell it.
V-I-C?
Mm-hmm.
You don't know.
I do not
know. Why do you do that?
I told you I didn't know how to spell
it. See, you are an asshole. That's why you know them so well.
I wasn't an asshole in school, though.
That's crazy.
I was not an asshole in school. I didn't become an asshole until I realized that's what girls like. And that wasn't until college.
You learned everything in college, though.
Yeah.
I don't think girls like assholes.
You would think.
We just want you to be able to, like, defend yourself.
No, it goes way beyond that.
You dealt with a specific cage of girls.
No, I did mad girls.
You did mad girls also.
I wasn't even talking about sexually, just in general. Just had different types of women. I was able to pull different types of women because I'm a nice guy.
Y'all all went to the same school?
No.
Most of y'all did?
No. Different schools, different area codes, you know?
Yo, you got to stop doing that, for real. Like, we've already discussed, you were a hoe. We get it. But that's the way you spread it out is just like...
No, I just want you to understand that it wasn't localized. There's nothing wrong with being a hoe,
but I just want you to claim it.
It wasn't localized. I've already claimed it, but, you know, I dealt with a lot of different women, and the one thing that stayed true was I couldn't get their attention unless I was being a little bit of an asshole. Okay. Couldn't keep their attention unless I was being a little bit of an asshole.
Damn, what does that say about your personality?
That it's built off of...
something you made up for tears. Women. It's built off women. You are a woman-made business, kind of, right? Woman-owned... female owned.
So do I get like a grant? Know,
probably a scholarship. You could probably get a grant. I think you can get a grant.
That would be dope.
Yeah, women built you.
I deserve
you.
It.
Women built you. You don't have a personality outside of women. Well,
my
mama built
me, so you know. No. My daddy was there too, but.
You don't have a personality outside of women.
That's bullshit. I had a personality before women. I just tweaked it because of women.
So you.
I stayed, the base was the same. I just added other things. To make it better, I added a little bit of a sense of humor.
Built by women.
No, not built, just tweaked. It's like you buy a Honda.
No.
And you're like, oh, this is a Honda, but when I finish with this shit gonna be a race car.
So we talking about Civics?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. And that's
Preludes.
Yeah, exactly. So you know, you get
a Prelude?
Yeah, I do.
Okay.
Get a spoiler.
Yo, niggas love Preludes. I dated this one dude, and that's all he ever wanted was a Prelude. And he finally got one, and he left me. I was like, damn, nigga, I wasn't worth a Prelude. Yo.
I realized what the real love in my life was.
Yeah, like, wow. Wow, they still, that's crazy. They don't even make those no more, I don't think.
Nah.
I don't think they make them no more. So look at him. Wow.
But I bet he still got it.
Yeah.
Kept you longer than him.
He might have done that. That's crazy. But I could have been fixed, and nobody knows how to fix a Prelude anymore.
You could have been fixed.
Yeah, if you didn't like something about me, that was at the time when I was moldable. I was young.
I'm about to say
No, let's talk about you.
What?
Built on the backs of women. Let's talk about you.
No.
Like, what kind of person do you think you would be outside of women influencing your
a lawyer?
I believe that. Oh, I wholeheartedly believe that. Because, nigga, you lie with the straightest of faces.
No.
Actually, you can't lie that. See, look
this
at this.
Goddamn phone.
There it go. Every time we record during the day, the phone want to act like it worked. There is.
I would be a lawyer. I would be a very serious lawyer.
You would be serious?
I would be
you
very serious.
You think women made you funny?
I didn't have a sense of humor.
So women made you funny?
I didn't have a sense of humor.
You know, a lot of women like funny men.
I know. So I learned. I don't know if you were like this, but because I never kept a huge
men didn't make me group, funny.
No, not that. Because I didn't have a huge friend group growing up, I always had like one person that was like my right hand. Mm. And when I started getting into girls, all of my right hand men were funny. Like, I remember in high school, my first right-hand man, my dude Sean, he was pulling all the joints.
You
now,
needed them. That's crazy.
Huh?
You was the one that just showed up and was like, why you bring your friend?
Nah. Sean was, like, I was a little more popular than Sean, but Sean knew everybody because of his sense of humor, and everybody loved Sean. All
were you
of the
popular
because
you could sing?
No. I don't know why I was pop. I wasn't popular in high school. I didn't get pop. You know what's really funny? I didn't get popular in high school until my senior year. And I don't even know if I can call that popular. I just think everyone knew me.
You were singing everywhere.
Singing and Mr. Bayside and...
If you sang in high school the way that you sing around the house, I would know you too. I'd be like, you talk about the nigga that just be singing in a corner?
No, I wasn't that guy.
You were?
No, not at all. But that's when Sean... Because Sean was a year older than me. Mm-hmm. So once he left school, I had to keep the comedy going. So I took how I looked at what was funny about him, and I took that and I continued that on my senior year.
That's
and
so
I think
funny.
That's how I started gaining friends.
That's so funny because I could just imagine y'all like while he in college and you in high school, y'all
he
have
never
a conversation.
College.
Okay, well,
don't want to put that on him.
Well, I didn't want to. All right, in this world where your friend went got an education outside of school and you were still in high school, I can imagine y'all having conversations outside. And he was like, I gotta use that. Because nobody ever heard it. Because he wasn't in school no more.
Exactly. Like, no, we wasn't. It wasn't like that. No,
you're
I
joke
literally.
Thief.
I literally. No, no, no. Never took a joke. I took the DNA of how he made jokes. Like, I learned what was funny about him. I studied him and was like, oh, that's what makes him funny. He's this type of funny. He puts his punchlines here. He does this.
That is so crazy because your best friend right now is a comedian.
Yeah.
Your wife is a comedian. Like, your wife is a comedian. And now I feel like you using us.
No.
Oh, my gosh. You have been using me this whole time. That's crazy. Your literal right-hand man right now is a comic. And you married a fucking...
A popular comic,
that
too.
Is great. A famous comedian. Like, this nigga said... Like, you accelerated all of your friends. It was something like you just moved your way up the ladder and now you reached the pinnacle with a famous-ass comic and your wife is now a comic. I gotta call this nigga Jay. I'm calling Jay. He been using us this whole time. You need us. Do you see this? Do you see what this podcast is? It's because I'm being an asshole.
No.
And you just here working with the DNA. Putting shit together. I am upset.
No.
Oh, my
God. I never looked at it like that, but...
You didn't... Your life, your whole life led you up to this moment. You just been playing with our emotions.
No.
And seeing what was good about us and putting it together and saying, I think it'd be really good like this. And we were just like, yeah, nigga, it would be good like this. This nigga is Megamind. That is crazy. Man. Damn.
That sounds sad. No.
But it makes so much sense, doesn't it? Now, you didn't even know this was happening to you.
I never looked
well,
at
we
it
didn't
like
know
that.
What was happening to us until right now. And this better be a clip, and I'm going to tag
this
Jay in it.
This is not a clip.
I'm going to text it to him. Look what he's been doing to us this whole time.
No, you know, I wanted to be, I think it all goes back to when I was really young, wanting to be accepted, and I had to learn ways of being accepted. And I felt like as the person I was to the core, mm-hmm. I wasn't accepted by many and I wanted to be accepted by many. Mm-hmm. So I learned there were different things that people did that made them accepted by the masses.
I'm so sorry because I was so concentrated on what you was doing to us that I forgot the story was sad for you.
Fuck you.
I was like, oh no. This whole time. I was like, oh no, this wasn't a happy story to begin with.
Yo.
But now I know it's because you did it.
Whatever.
We didn't start the show.
You want to start the show?
I don't know. Should we? You tell me what my mind is thinking right now. Mr. Puppeteer ass nigga, let's go. What are we doing? Fuck. So mad at you.
It's J-Rod.
Kristen Sivills.
And then we had Sexy Podcast, the fastest growing podcast in Green Hill, Tennessee.
Hey, burr, 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 burr. Where's that?
That is close to Nashville.
Okay, and we will be in Nashville.
Yes, we will be in Nashville on August 20th.
Dang, that's crazy.
I'm starting to memorize the dates.
I don't know them. You know, I can barely remember
what
really,
I ate
yesterday.
The beginning and the ends of the dates. Like, I know where we're beginning, and I know where we're going to be ending around the summertime. So,
okay. Yeah. I'm excited.
Not saying that we end the tour during the summertime, but that's, you know.
I'm excited about Nashville. I love St. Louis.
No, definitely. This podcast is sponsored by BetterHelp Therapy Online. If you want to live a more empowered life, therapy can get you there. Visit BetterHelp.com/ATWHS today to get 10% off your first month.
Yes.
How was your week? Don't worry about it. I'll tell you about my week.
Wait, hold on. I don't think I did. No, I know how my week was. I got sick. 2 days ago.
That's nice.
The babies got sick. Everybody got sick this week. So my week has been taking care of all of you. Every last one of you.
What do you mean? You didn't take care of me.
Yes,
I
did.
You let me sit in a corner.
Hold on. I didn't take care of you? I didn't get up multiple times a night to take you to the bathroom and make sure you was okay?
Whoa. I don't like the way you said that.
Because it's true?
Maybe that's why.
You needed to get to the bathroom and you were in pain and I kept getting up to make sure that you were okay because you were in pain. So I didn't take care of you? I didn't keep asking you if you was good. Did
but
you
I
need
told
anything?
You I, was good.
I didn't make sure that you was good. No, you weren't good. No, you weren't.
But if I tell you I'm good, I'm good.
No, you needed me. I said, do you need me?
You wanted me to need you.
And did you? I said, do you need me?
I would
and
have
you
made
was
it.
Like, yeah. And I went and I helped you. Don't do that. I didn't get no sleep because of y'all most of the time.
Whoa. You would not blame all of your non-sleep
no,
on me.
No, all of it. I said, y'all. Everybody was sick. Everybody had something going on. One time we woke up the next morning and one of the babies had thrown up in the bed and we didn't even hear it. We didn't know. So after that, I was like, I have to stay up because I don't know what's wrong with everybody.
You know what? And I don't say this enough. You are a really good mother.
Thank you. I feel like something's coming after me.
No, nothing's coming after. No. No, you're a really good mother. Like, when the baby threw up and you couldn't sleep the next night, I was like, yo, that's crazy because I'm getting all of my sleep.
I mean, you and your sleep apnea machine was going
out
to work.
Of sight.
And I kept getting up to make sure they were okay. There was a couple of times where the baby was coughing or like something. And I know you probably didn't hear it. And I was taking care of everybody. And then the big girl got sick. And then I was... like, and then yesterday she had some things and then I had to run to go take care. Like, I've been running and like making sure everything has been running.
No, I get that. Like,
this whole time.
You were super mom this week. Like, no bullshit. Yeah.
So that's been my week. And then I got sick and I was out. I don't know. It was some kind of virus or something going on.
Yeah, like
around.
A 24-hour virus. It was crazy.
Yeah, but so that's been my week. And then preparing for today.
But you haven't been able to, and I feel bad for you.
Yeah, I haven't. If y'all coming to the show tonight, if you hear this,
well, let them know about the show.
So I'm headlining Virginia Beach Funny Bone tonight, March 30th. There are tickets still available because honestly, and I'm going to be completely straight up, like I haven't been promoting it for real. We have so many dates with the podcast that sometimes I forget that I have a job outside of the podcast and I haven't really been talking about it, but there are tickets available. A lot of people still don't know, but if you hear this, I guess, and you know, come to the show. But I've been trying to prepare for the show for a while and every time I try to prepare for it, something happens. So I don't know what I'm going to say tonight. So y'all just show up, I guess. I don't know. It'll be something.
That was not something that would make me say purchase.
No. Well, why? Just come. Come see me fuck up. I don't know. Like, it's going to be a show either way.
That's a little closer.
Yeah.
I might hit purchase on that.
On the show with me is Liz Barlow, one of the hosts of the Fluffy Chronicles podcast, and Brene Williams. So
I went to school with Brene.
Yes. Brene can sing.
Yo, I wasn't even going to say that. I was going to stick to her comedy. But yeah, Brene can sing her ass off.
I told her she got to sing me a processional when I come in. I was like, I'm going to call you back to the stage so you can do my intro song.
Yo, Brene is a singing ass. But what I remember was being in by school, I mean college, we were in choir together. Mm-hmm. And what I remember is going on choir tours and her being in the back of the bus and having the entire fucking bus in stitches. Like, just naturally fucking funny, man.
Brene is hilarious.
Yes.
Like, what's funny is that every time we've gotten together, because this week I went and did this local talk, like lifestyle talk show that they have, the Hampton Roads show. And we were in the green room. And the whole time, we are just joking. Everybody, we're just roasting each other. And I was like, this should be the show. I should just call everyone on stage and we just roast each other for an hour. Like, that's all we were doing the entire time. And it was some other people in the green room and they would like have a conversation with themselves and like look at us. And I was like, they probably jealous of all the fun that we had. Because Liz was like, man, they probably want to slit our throats. We over here just having a good ass time. Like they're so funny. So it's
going to
be
a good show.
Yeah.
I'm kind of sad. I'm going to miss it.
Yeah. Watching kids.
Yeah. But it's all good. It's all good. I'm glad that you're getting on stage.
Yeah.
Because you haven't. Well, no, you were on stage last month. You've been doing like one gig a month.
Yeah. But I want to do more. I do want to get on stage more. I got a lot of stuff to talk about, but I have ADHD and I ain't on medicine, so sometimes I'll be forgetting. but I mean, that's being honest. If you listen to the podcast, you know that. But I think it'll be fun. I think it'll be fun either way. Because I mean, everybody's cool. I'm excited. I'm excited to see what happens. Yeah,
that's what's up. My week was interrupted, man. Interrupted. I don't know what I had planned for this week, but whatever it was, didn't get done because my foot decided to just die on me. Like, legit, it quit. I didn't know body parts could just do that without, like, prior notice.
At this point, I think you should expect that from your body.
And, like, where do you...
Your body, though.
Where do you go get new bodies?
I don't know. I think my body's doing okay. Except for this arm. I don't know what's going on with this arm. But no, I think honestly, so tell them what you think led up to it.
Oh, that's right.
Yeah. Wait a minute.
Oh, yeah. So you guys know I've been on a fitness journey and it's been up and down. But I try to get in there as much as I can. And right before our Boston show, I got with my trainer. And
say his name,
Bricks. Pull up his Instagram.
Is it Bricks Fitness?
Now, let me tell you, this man is one of the best trainers that I've ever worked with. He's just a kind, beautiful soul. Like, when you're around him, you feel better.
He really does have a beautiful soul. He just seems like a yogi, peaceful.
He is, and he's super into yoga now.
It's Bricks Fitness, B-R-I-X Fitness on Instagram.
But now that I've said that, and you guys can DM him.
No, that's why we said his name, because y'all got to blame him for breaking my baby.
Yes, Bricks with an X. We were in the gym right before Boston, and we're going in, and he was like, all right, I want you to do some planks. And I was like, bro, I don't know if I could do planks. And he's just has this way about just motivating you.
Yeah, you can do anything you put your
mind. Yeah, exactly. Yeah, so I get out there the first one. I'm like, and I'm fighting through it. He was like, you did good, man. Do it again. And I said, And then by like the third or fourth one, I was like, oh, I got this. But I knew before we started those planks, this wasn't the exercise for me.
How many planks did you do?
We did like four for like 60 seconds or some shit like that. By the way, we're doing different exercises in between. So I would do the plank, then do a shoulder press or something like that. Like we were hitting it. So I knew that he knew that I was dying that day because he asked me before I left the gym, was that too hard for you? You know, I don't ever want you to feel like you can't continue your whole day and work after you've been in the gym with me. And I was like,
you know what I don't like about that is that he asked you after the day was done.
Oh yeah, it wasn't like he was going to stop
that
day. I
appreciate that.
And he asked me and I was like, nah bro, I got it. Because I wasn't going to look like no bitch in front of this big Terminator looking motherfucker. You know what I mean? Anyway, so I leave and we go to Boston. And the night we got into Boston, I was like, my foot, it's feeling a little weird. As a matter of fact, I switched my sneakers that I was going to wear that day just because my foot was just feeling mad crazy. But, you know, I didn't think anything of it. You know, go to Greenville, same thing. My foot, you know, it's just not feeling up to it. But it all came to a head last Friday when I woke up and I put my feet on the floor and I realized I couldn't put both feet on the floor. Like, literally, my foot was saying, nigga, no, we are done. It's over. And I tried to walk and I couldn't. I stumbled, almost knocked down my boxes of sneakers.
Yeah, that's a whole nother conversation.
That's a tower.
That's a whole nother conversation.
But anyway, so I hobbled around. I'm thinking maybe it's just, you know, going to be over in the next day. It would not be over. I went to the ER. They didn't find anything on the x-rays. So now I'm like, I don't know if they think I'm lying, but they're not going to give me no pain medicine.
Yeah, I think they thought she was joking because he was like, it hurt. And they was like, well, we don't see any reason for it to hurt. And they would not give this man drugs
at
all.
I was in so much pain, like agonizing pain.
Did you start questioning your sanity? Like, I know what I feel.
No, I lie to you not. There was a moment where I was like, is this all in my head?
Like, I know it hurt. I know I feel
right,
something.
Exactly.
Yeah, I could see it on your face.
Yeah, because it, oh man.
You were genuinely like depressed.
Yo, because I was in so much pain and I had no idea. Usually, like if I have a pain, I know where it comes from. But this one, I had no idea where it came from. It wasn't a normal place that I'm usually in pain. Mm. So it just really threw me completely off. And I could not get an appointment to a foot and ankle doctor for like until this week. So I get to the foot and ankle doctor. They say that I might have torn like a chicken tender or something like that in my fifth and sixth.
Chicken tender? You say a tendon.
That's all I remember hearing. And they wrap my foot up and, you know, I've been in this cast and boot for the last couple of days.
I mean, just hopping everywhere. And that also leads to the fact that I just be having to do everything because you can't go nowhere.
No, who can? But I drove.
He been trying to do stuff, but it's been, you know.
I ain't going to just sit down and chill. That's not me.
You don't know how to do that.
Mm-mm, hell no. But, you know, so my week has been very blah because I ain't been able to really do shit but sit in pain. But the pain has been subsiding, which makes me a little angry because I'm like, if it subsides too much, by the time I go get my MRI, they might not see anything. And then I won't know.
Then they
what
really
the fuck
gonna
happened.
Think you crazy.
Right.
Yeah.
You know, right. So it's like a catch 22, man.
It's all right.
Ugh.
That wasn't sexy at all. Let's talk about something else.
We ain't fucked cause my foot. No, I take that back. Thursday.
You do take that back?
Yeah, Thursday. The night before my foot was on fire, mm-hmm. We did fuck. And you was like, you sure you want to do that with your foot? And I was like,
I did say that.
And I was like, hell yeah, I want to do that.
My foot all right.
Yeah.
I was like, okay.
Yeah, and it was, hey.
It was sex. And don't do that. It wasn't the best. It was sex. You thought it was the best? You was in it and was like, oh my God, this is the best.
I didn't say it was the best, but.
You thought it was substantial.
You didn't.
No, it was cool. It was cool. We had sex. We didn't make love. Oh, we did make love. Oh, you was feeling on me, right? That was slow. My sex is getting intertwined. Was that the day it was slow? Was it? Was it fast? Was it slow? Like, you was rubbing on me, and I was like, oh.
Yes.
Oh, that's that day. No, that shit was good. You was fucking me.
No, you can't do that now.
No, I didn't
now.
Know what day it was. It's getting, because we haven't had sex because of that.
So it should be very easy to.
No, I thought we talked about that last week. I thought that was the last time, but if that was the time, then no, we was.
Oh, wait, maybe I got it mixed up.
I think you got it mixed up. I think we talked about that last week.
Yeah, but I could have sworn it was good.
Okay. And I'm going to go with your word because, you know, remember I said ADHD is crazy. You just, when you ain't on meds, you have brain fog.
So, if it's good to me, mm-hmm. but ain't great for you.
Should you even care? Right?
It's like a philosophy question. Mm-mm. You know, the tree falls in the forest. Is anyone around to hear it?
Oh.
It's like that. So.
You was around to hear it? I was there too. I heard you.
You heard me nut.
Mm-hmm. That's cool.
So it happened.
Yeah.
It cool. Well, that's all I give a fuck about.
Yeah,
then.
I know that is all you give a fuck about.
Confession of the week.
Confession of the week. I hated you a little bit this week. Because this whole week, you couldn't do nothing at all. You were just like, I can't do anything. And then the other day, you wanted to go to the podcast, to the live podcast, to Matt Skills. Shout out to them, Hip Hop Confessions. Shout out to him. But you were just like going to build up all your energy to go to that podcast.
Mm-hmm.
And the days before that, you act like you could not even stay awake to help me in any capacity.
I was drugging myself. I couldn't stay awake to help you in any capacity.
But you were going to risk it all to go hop out on that leg.
Whoa, you got it. So Friday, the pain. Saturday, the pain. Sunday, the pain. Monday, no, went to the ER, but got more pain. That was on Wednesday, right? Mm-hmm. Got sick on Tuesday. Mm-hmm. But I had been drugging myself since Monday. So by Wednesday, I wasn't drugging myself as much.
I just had resentment or something because I had been, felt like I've been moving constantly and doing everything. And then you was like, I'm going to leave and go do this. You didn't go because you realized that was stupid, but you were ready to just be like, fuck it. I don't care. It's fine. I want to go do this. And I was like, I am tired. I don't want to do, if you could do that, you could sit here with these kids for a minute. You could do something. Like, I don't,
well,
I'm tired.
I did say I was going to wait till the kids were like down.
Yeah. I mean, you didn't go, but yeah, at first I was like, this nigga, I am.
That's honest. And I appreciate your honesty.
You want me
and
to
I,
lie for the confession of the week?
No. And I apologize if you felt that way.
Yes.
That wasn't what I was trying to give off.
Yes. Thank you. I appreciate that.
I just wanted to go see the homie.
Me too. I wanted support. To go. I wanted to go more than anything, but I didn't feel good that day, and I knew I couldn't have gone anywhere. But, yeah. What about you? Confession of the week. Well, nothing really wrong with my foot.
Shit. Confession of the week. And this is going to sound wild after your confession. But confession of the week is I really have to take the time I said I was going to take for myself to go to the movies more. I told you it was going to sound wild after that. I understand that it sounds like I'm being an asshole, and I'm not. I promise I'm not. And I
don't touch me. Don't touch me.
I take in what you gave and I ingest it and I secrete it.
Ew. Don't do that. Whatever I gave you, don't secrete nothing. Don't secrete nothing I gave you. That's nasty.
Okay. Okay. I take in what you've given me and I absorb it.
Okay.
And I will, in the future, not be dead. I don't know, but I hear you. Mm-hmm. What I'm saying is, I missed John Wick 4 in IMAX.
You did,
and I
shame.
Really, I've been wanting to see that movie in IMAX for what, better part of a year and a half now.
Shame, that's crazy.
And I was like, this is bullshit. That's one of the things that I do for myself. Like, I remember you asked me, it might have even been on a podcast last week. I'm not sure. We were talking, and he was like, but what do you do for yourself? And I told you I like to work. That's my thing, working.
The movies is also your thing. Yes,
yeah.
You love the movies.
Yeah, like, and that's like one of the only things that I
It doesn't
ever
sound
had.
That crazy from, I'm talking about this week specifically because it just, I was so tired of just doing stuff that I was like, all right, I need a second, like,
no,
where
I
can
that.
Just concentrate on myself. But I am completely for you, you know, like, I want to go to the movie. Like, you love the movies. You love going to the movies by yourself. That's your thing. I don't want to take that away from you. It was just so sudden after.
No, I get that. And
being
I get
exhausted.
That.
Yes.
I get that. And that's why yesterday, because we didn't have to, like, go out yesterday.
Yeah.
But, you know, I know we were both in here, and I was like, well, that would be dope just for us to get out and just get a change of pace for a second. We actually, we did that yesterday. Went out to Angus Black's
open mic. At Bonchon.
Man, listen, if you got a Bonchon in your area, the chicken is wild, B.
Okay. All right. Yeah, it was good.
Man, but it sat on my belly.
Did it?
The whole night.
I don't want to talk about any more food. I'm actually starving. I haven't eaten yet.
Oh,
so.
I'm sorry. But yeah, that's question of the week. Let's get to the question of the day. And today's question of the day, what does your partner do to make you smile?
Can I just say something?
What?
I think this might have something to do with my question of the my answer. I love your voice so much. It was just like you went into like radio mode just then, and that shit was kind of sexy to me. I forgot all about that leg. You hear me? That leg didn't have nothing to do with nothing just now. It was something about that. It was so professional and just sexy. Jeez.
Whatever, man.
What does your partner do to make you smile? I don't know. I mean, you do a lot of things. I think when we have conversations, I mean, most of the times we end up running into a joke or something like that, and laughing with you is just, that sounds so corny, but I like laughing with you. Like, if we're both just in a zone where we're joking and shit like that.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know if that's a good answer.
No, I get it.
I mean, our humor is the same, so I like laughing with you. But also, I just like seeing you with the kids. That shit's sexy as hell. And I don't want to be turned on because you're playing with kids. But, because that feels weird, even though they're my kids. But, like, it's something about that. Something about that shit is so, oh, my gosh. And I've said that before. Like, I was a single mom for so long. I was a single mom for 10 years with my baby. Well, no, it was probably 9 years with Kaden. So, like, coming into a situation where I have a partner and, like, you a good dad and they like you, like, that shit is nice to look at. I'd observe it sometimes. I just be like, oh, I was about to say something. It's gonna sound terrible. I'm gonna suck that dick. I'm gonna kiss that face. I don't know. I was gonna sound something that was gonna, it was gonna sound bad, but wow. I like that shit. What about you? What does your partner do to make you smile, assuming that I'm your partner?
It licks my balls. That makes me smile.
That is.
Because the way you do it.
Not the answer that I wanted you to say.
You didn't want that answer?
I wanted you to say, like, I come into a room.
I come into
a room. I know you do. Look at where. Look at how we cannot. How do I know what you about to say? Oh my gosh. I gotta get away from you. We need some time apart. I knew you was gonna say you come into a room. You've been around me way too long, I think.
I think
that's what it is. Yeah.
Oh man. But nah. I smile when you do that.
Uh-huh.
Okay, let's find some sentimental shit.
You gotta find it.
What does my partner do to make me smile? I think that would be, you care with your whole heart. Like, legit. When you care about someone, something, whatever, you put your whole being into it. And that shit makes me smile because I don't know many people that have that capacity to do that. Because a lot of times when you do things like that, it can sometimes take away from your own self. And you put your all into everything you care about, including me. And that shit feels amazing. It makes me a lucky man.
Oh, that's very nice. I do care. I feel like sometimes I might be to my detriment because I care so much about everything. I'm such an empath. It's crazy. Mm-hmm. But, oh.
Yeah, but when you lick them balls, though, my nigga.
Never just be nice to me. Damn. All right, let's look at some of these answers that y'all have. What does your partner do to make you smile? She's loving me in my love language. She knows what I need in certain times, and I love her for that. That's important, I think, to make sure you understand love language instead of just being like, well, I love you like this, and it should work. And it's like, but is this the way I want to be loved?
Yeah, that's whack.
Like,
that's
yeah.
whack. Yeah. Like, because let's be real. If you don't love a person the way they need to be loved, then you're not really loving them.
Yeah.
You're loving yourself.
Yeah. It's like, nah, I feel like I'm doing everything. Like, I always want to dig deeper into the people that are like, I did everything. I gave you everything. And it's like, what if I didn't want you to give me any? Like, what if I just wanted you here?
Oh, my gosh. I used to get mad at the girls that would be mad at me for cheating. They were like, oh, my gosh.
Wait, what?
Let me finish.
Okay.
They'd be like, oh my gosh, I gave you everything. I did this. I did this. I did this. And I'd be like, but I didn't ask you to do none of that.
And that's not even, it sounds like a terrible response, but honestly, that's not a bad response. That's not what I wanted from you. I wanted this and you couldn't give me this. But you also have to be the one to communicate that though. You can't just be like, why? She should, if she know me, she should know.
No, I communicate it. I communicate the fuck out of it. I don't want you to do that. I'm good. Yeah, it's sad because a lot of times when you say that to a person, they could be the person that says, nah, but this is what you need.
There's also that. But there are certain things that you need that you don't. Like, you just need, you need guidance sometimes.
I don't be wanting that shit, though.
I know, you don't be wanting. And, then
and
you,
I'm supposed to.
You get led into the wrong direction, though. Sometimes you do need guidance.
Fuck you. You no, do. Listen, there are certain things that I need. There are certain things that I want. And if you give me things that I need and I don't want it, mm-hmm. I'm not going to appreciate it the way you want me to.
You probably need to appreciate some things. Like yesterday, your mother took you to, she drove you to go make sure you were good with your foot.
Yes.
And because I couldn't go.
Yes.
And the whole entire time, she was texting me what the doctor was saying, what you need to do when you got home, what number you needed to call, what the doctor's name was, everything. And you needed that. Because if I'd have been like, baby, what happened at the appointment? You'd be like, I don't know, man. They just wrapped my foot up. Like, there are things you need for general survival. You would have done that. I'd have been like, yo, what happened at the doctor? You'd be like, I don't know. I saw the doctor came in and they said some shit. And they're like, I don't know, this thing on my foot. Like, you never communicate. There are some things you need. That you need me, but I understand what you're saying when it comes to like love languages, like for you to be like, well, you need this to like fully feel loved.
Yeah.
That's completely different. But like for general survival, sometimes you gotta listen. I don't know how you made it this long.
I would survive.
I don't know how you made it this long. Every day.
Because like, I hate when, and you do the same thing my mother does. I hate when I go and talk to somebody and then I come back and then you're like, yo, what did they say? Because I can't recall everything they said and y'all want details and shit.
Yeah.
And I'm like, I don't have those for you. I know the basics. I know that my foot was wrapped. Mm-hmm. I know they said my chicken tender was fucked up on the 6 and the 7. Mm-hmm. And at the end of the day, I got to get an MRI.
Yeah, but you wouldn't have known the number. You
no, I had
known
the number.
Nothing.
It was part of the papers.
Nah, it's something, I know, but.
Yeah, now you would have said, well, what the chicken tender is? I don't know. It's a chicken tender.
You gotta stop saying chicken tender. It's a tendon. It's just weird when you say it like that, because I'm very hungry. I'm so hungry.
That's some greedy shit,
so
man.
So hungry.
What's something that your partner does to make you smile? When he thanks me for dinner and compliments on how good it was.
Yeah.
Aw. She looks so wholesome.
Yeah.
Like, she be cooking.
I
don't even think it's that good.
I be cooking. You don't think I look wholesome, though? It's a contrast. I don't know what to think of you.
What you mean?
I don't be cooking. Don't say that. No, don't. No. Don't let me say I be cooking and you be like, huh. Don't fucking do that. No. Don't do that.
Now you be cooking, son.
I cook my ass off when I want to, right?
And that is...
That's the part. But don't act like I can't cook.
I never said that you couldn't cook.
All right. Don't...
I am on record saying that you are an amazing cook.
All right. I just want to throw that out there.
Also on record saying that I haven't eaten your cooking in a while.
Okay. No, I've cooked, though, in the last...
But did you?
We've been so busy, I haven't been cooking. I just don't want you to think that I don't know how to get these pans hot around here.
Listen, how busy you got to be to not put so much salt in the chicken, though?
Oh, I did that last time because I was rushing. I don't know.
And that's the last meal
you know
I have,
why? Because
and I'm going
I hadn't
off of
been because I hadn't been in practice, and even I ate it. I was like, damn, what did
say
I
it
do?
Again? You haven't been what? Mm-hmm.
In practice.
There you go. There you go.
Well, why don't you start practicing? Why don't you step up?
Yo, son, you don't want that.
You've done it before in like the very beginning when you were trying to woo me.
Yeah, gotcha.
What is something your partner does that makes you smile? He reads my mind before I can get out what I'm thinking. Uh-huh. I don't know if that will make me smile. Sometimes it scares me when you do it. He lets me be the big spoon, toot it out for me, stink.
Nah, fuck that.
I love being a big spoon.
Fuck
and I
that.
Be trying to, I got to make him let me do
I
it.
I am a man. Sometimes, and you will not big spoon me.
I fucking love it.
You won't big spoon
it's
me.
It's really me just trying to like be on your back. Like I
want
to wrap my legs around
you
your
on
back.
My back.
I want to wrap your leg, my legs around your back.
No.
Put my vagina to your tailbone.
What kind of sex is that?
No, it's not sex. It's cuddling. It's intimacy.
Mm-mm.
You don't like that?
I don't want to be that intimate. Not big spoon. You can't be that.
They allow me to vent about my day without trying to problem solve and actually listen to what I'm saying. Wow, that must be nice. I'm just playing. You do that. But I don't have to vent about my day because you be in my day.
Every day.
What does your partner do to make you smile? She signed that divorce decree. Fuck out of here.
Yeah. I don't fuck with you.
Yeah. Why are you so excited about a divorce?
No, I'm just saying. I'm happy
with
you.
Just put guns up. What did you just do? They can't see it on audio. No. Why do you do that?
Nah, I'd be happy when people get divorces, man. Like for them.
Yeah.
Because if you divorce.
It's for them. It's for not just because y'all getting a divorce, but at least you are getting yourself out of a situation
you get
don't want
to start
be in.
Anew. Like, you know what I mean? Because man, to divorce, being in a marriage, you realize if you got married for the right reasons, you realize how hard it has to be to get a divorce and how much turmoil you have to be in and how unhappy you have to be every single day in order to say, I'm gonna get a divorce. Yeah. So I'm happy for people that get that spirit off of them. You know what I mean? Because life is short, man.
When something your partner does to make you smile, I'm getting out of the bed for work and he pulls me back into bed. That will piss me off. Like, nigga, I gotta go. I got money to make. What's wrong with you?
That sounds like he's just trying to get you a little.
Yeah, but I'm gonna be late. Fuck, bills ain't gonna pay themselves. Get off me.
Nigga, I'm paying bills too. I just want to get a little.
Yeah, but if I don't come up with, if I, what are you talking about?
Action.
Okay. Yeah, but I'm getting fired from my job. No, you can get someone, I get back.
See, that's the problem.
She gets excited over a new purchase or accomplishment. Her face lights the room. Oh, that's nice. I get excited about new purchases. You don't smile about that.
Because you get new purchases every fucking day.
No,
Sephora
I don't.
Sephora coming to the door.
No, I haven't gotten Sephora in a while. I know you
got Sephora last week.
Nigga, shut up in your surprise ass tennis shoes that show up at the door. Leave me alone.
That's a surprise to you.
Nope. But they're your shoes. he calls me baby girl. He cuddles up to me in his sleep. Somebody else said, I see him. Yeah.
What's something that your partner does to make you smile? He calls me for no reason. That makes you smile. You sound like it is easy to keep you.
Listen, that would interrupt my day. What do you want? I'm in the middle of doing something.
Calls me for no. And like, what do you talk about when you get calls for no reason?
I just want to hear your voice.
And say what?
I just want to hear your voice.
That's weird.
You think so?
Yes.
I mean, I like your voice though. I fuck with your voice.
That's why I leave a voice message. Just one. So you can play it over and over again.
No, I don't have to do that right now because we're always together. he goes out of his way to make me, our boy, smile. That's nice.
What does your partner do to make you smile? She farts.
Oh, well, that is a kink.
Definitely
no,
a kink.
And no kink shaming.
Definitely a kink.
No kink shaming. he does the damn dishes. He fixes the small things I complain about. See, paying attention. That's a big one. I like that.
She didn't say that. She just said he fixes the small things I complain about.
That's paying attention. I complain about small things. It's not something that'll stick out in your head, but you know that if this is done, I'll be a little bit happier. That's good. Mm. What is something your partner does to make you smile? She gets excited about the gifts I buy her. Well, I think most people get excited about gifts.
No, not at all.
I'm saying like...
I you know... It's hard for me to accept gifts.
Yeah.
So sometimes I don't want to receive gifts because I don't want to make a person feel like they went out their way for nothing because I don't know how to outwardly show, hey, thank you.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? So yeah. No, that's something I think.
What's something that makes your partner smile? I get a forehead kiss. Okay.
Yo, ever since Tay Diggs said that endearing forehead kiss on The Best Man, y'all been acting like that forehead kiss is the shit.
I think I like it. I like it when it comes out of nowhere. My arm really hurts. I'm sorry. That has nothing to do with anything, but my arm really hurts.
The forehead
just
kiss.
Give him out, huh?
What?
He was just,
when I found out that was what y'all liked, I
was
like,
just
that's
palming
it?
Foreheads, huh?
All salty shit, too.
Just
ugh.
Two hand palming heads and leaning them in, huh?
Nah, right there.
Like basketball.
I'm telling you.
Got an assembly line of just forehead kisses.
You line up.
You would. he feeds me and rubs my feet. Damn, I don't get any of those.
Because you don't like your feet rubbed.
You don't. I've asked you to do it before.
No, you haven't.
I don't like it when...
I've asked you to rub your feet.
I don't like it when I don't have... my feet ain't done.
Most of the time, they ain't done. They ain't done.
No, they be done.
When?
They haven't been done since the last time. That's not fair. But I get my feet done. Fine. Pay for me to get my feet done again.
That's not a problem. Yeah. I be asking you.
Baby, my feet are... Stop, because this. Oh, every time we do this, it makes it seem like my feet ugly.
I never said
your
feet
ugly.
Or I don't
get my feet done. I do get my feet done. I hadn't gotten them done, but I'd get my feet done. All right. Texting me randomly. I like that. Because it's like, oh, you was thinking about me. I like that.
We got to get away from each other, man.
Okay, bye.
No, I'm just saying, like,
can you take kids with you though? Because every time you get away from me, you leave me with kids.
Nah, I'm just talking about like away, you know? Like, I might go get like a job at a school being like a lunch lady or something. Just so I could be away for a couple of hours.
First of all, the fact that you said you have to be a lunch lady is very discriminatory because you think only the ladies are in the back making the food. You think that's all we good for is cooking? For real. You think only the women should be in the kitchen?
Y'all run the kitchen.
Yeah. No. Why you can't just be a lunch man?
Do you want to get your food from a lunch man?
Who's the man? You know, most of the chefs are that they see on TV are men.
Nah, I'm talking about I want to be the person scooping and dumping.
Yeah, I don't like the way you even said that.
What?
Because I want somebody that's going to tell me I'm going to put the food on your plate. I don't want nobody to say they're going to scoop and dump.
Nah, look, them beans.
Like, you don't even care enough about the food.
Flop the...
Nah, I'm cool on that.
Flop the burger on
and
the plate.
You said flop. I don't like none of this. No. What is something that your partner does to make you smile when he has his walls down and he's himself not worried about judgment? Yeah. When he grabs me out of nowhere, like ass, boobs... Pussy. That's you.
Yeah, man. I grabbed the pussy earlier this morning.
You did this morning. It was too early to grab the pussy, too.
What you mean?
It wasn't even like a good pussy grab. It wasn't ready.
What makes a good pussy grab?
I don't know. Like a...
Because I try to put my fingers in it when I do it.
I know. But it's just... I don't know. It's just early. I don't know.
You got to wake it up. Wake up, pussy.
But wait until my eyes are open. Yeah, when he does random acts of romance or when I catch him admiring me. You don't ever admire me.
I be admiring you.
No, you don't.
Okay.
You just be looking at me like, why are you just sitting there? You should be doing something.
No, that's what you think.
Yeah, that's what you be doing.
That's what you think,
aren't you
man.
Supposed to be doing something right now? Why are you just sitting on the couch?
No.
Relaxing.
No. I do that when you're staring in space.
It's 5 o'clock. You should be in there making dinner.
No, that's what Caleb does to you.
Oh, that... I hate them. Them little twin boys, boy, they will come in there. Cameron came in the kitchen one time and asked me to make something. I was like, okay. And then he came in the kitchen to check and see what I was doing. And I happened to look at my phone. He was like, mommy, kitchen. I was like, I'm in the kitchen. What else do you want me to do?
Oh,
or if I step
man.
Out for a second, like they'll be mad. Mommy, let's go. And they'll drag me in the kitchen. Like, you're not supposed to be out here talking to nobody until my food is done.
Or if it's their time to eat, they bring you in the kitchen.
Oh, they don't play. Yeah. They don't play. All these husbands I got. If y'all don't know, we're on tour right now. You should know at this point. We were just talking to people on IG Live and they act like they didn't know the date. So hopefully you listening to the podcast.
Yeah.
April 13th, that's coming up. Hoover/Birmingham, Alabama. We're going to be at Stardom. Those tickets are still on sale now. April 15th, Philly City Winery. That is sold out, but we just added a new date. I'm going to tell y'all that a little bit later. April 21st, Chicago City Winery. That is also sold out, but we added another date. April 22nd, Virginia Beach Funny Bone. This is a newer date that we added in here, but there's two shows. Those tickets are on sale now, so please get your tickets. May 6th and 7th, we're going to be in Charlotte at the Comedy Zone. That's three shows. Those tickets are on sale now. All these tickets are on sale now, I think. May 12th, St. Louis City Winery. Those tickets are on sale. June 1st, Cleveland, Ohio at the Improv. June 4th, Detroit House of Comedy. I believe that's two shows. Last time we were in Detroit, they sold out pretty fast. So make sure you get those tickets very soon. June 8th, Tampa, Florida, the Improv. June 11th, Orlando, Florida at the Improv.
I'm excited about Orlando and Tampa just because I've never been.
We went to Tampa.
Oh.
We did Side Splitters.
You're right.
We did Side Splitters last time.
It's Orlando.
Yeah, we've never been to Orlando. But we're excited about Tampa, too, because we had a good time at Side Splitters. But we're at the Improv.
Oh, yeah. Side Splitters was dope.
Yeah. So June 11th, Orlando at the Improv. July 1st, New York City Winery.
Those tickets are expected to sell fast, so you might want to get them as soon as possible.
Yeah, I'm going to let y'all. They going already, and it's in July.
Yeah, and I'm telling you right now, it seems like the year is going by super quick. So don't say, oh, it's in a couple of months.
I wait. Those Chicago and Philly tickets from April were sold out for like 2 months. They've been sold out for a while. Yeah, they've been sold out for a while. July 6th, Tacoma, Super Funny Comedy Club. Super excited about those. Those tickets are on sale now. July 8th, Atlanta City Winery. Two shows, right? two shows. Those tickets are on sale. I know that at least one of them is like halfway sold out already, and that's in July. So get your tickets. And Atlanta sells pretty fast, so get those. July 15th, Dallas, Texas Theater. VIP is already sold out. And that's July 15th. So make sure you get your tickets because y'all complained about them Texas days, boy, and we got them in here. July 28th, Chicago City Winery. That's the new added date, and those tickets are on sale now. So make sure that you get those tickets. That's July 28th, Chicago City Winery. That's the new date that we added for Chicago. August 6th, Houston, Texas. We're going to be at the Houston Improv. So that's another one of those days that is going to sell pretty fast because we've been waiting for Houston for a minute. So those tickets are on sale now. That's August 6th, the Houston Improv. What are you doing? August 18th is the new Philly date at the City Winery. That's the added date.
Yeah, second show.
Right? What?
Yeah, the second show.
Yeah, that's the second show. Yeah,
I don't want you to say new.
That's the second show because the other one sold out. So August 18th, Philly City Winery. August 20th, Nashville at Zany's. So all these tickets are on sale now. I think that the Philly tickets go on sale Friday.
Yes. They'll all be on, and then we have sex.com. So you can go and get your tickets right there or just go to the websites of the actual places, whichever is easier for you. But like I said, it'll be on, and then we have sex.com under the events tab, if I'm not mistaken.
And we still have a bunch of other dates that we are adding. Yes. So please be patient with us. We just got to get the dates back from the venues and work all the stuff out.
If you haven't heard your city, doesn't mean that we're not coming. It's just we're trying to get out the spring and summer dates out first.
Yeah.
And then we'll be announcing fall and winter dates soon following.
Yeah, so just hold tight, bear with us. But get your tickets now, like soon, because I'm seeing people already like, y'all were coming to Philly and Chicago and they've been sold out for 2 months. And it's like, yeah, we added new dates for y'all, but we can't add new dates at every venue. So please get your tickets ASAP. Yep. This episode is brought to you by BetterHelp Therapy Online. For 10% off your first month, go to betterhelp.com/ATWHS. Start living a better life today. Therapy is all about deepening your self-awareness and understanding because sometimes we don't know what we want or why we react the way we do until we talk through things. I know that is specifically very, very important for me. If you're thinking of giving therapy a try, BetterHelp is a great option. It's convenient, flexible, affordable, and entirely online.
That right there is such a big thing because you don't have to leave the comfort of your home in order to get the therapy that you need.
Yeah. Just fill out a brief questionnaire to get matched with a licensed therapist and switch therapists anytime for no additional charge, which I think is great because if you find somebody that you don't click with, that's okay. You can find somebody else that fits you better. You don't have to just stick with the same person. Discover your potential with BetterHelp. Visit betterhelp.com/ATWHS today to get 10% off your first month. That's BetterHelp, HELP.com/ATWHS.
All right.
Yeah.
Let's get into the topics for today. sticking on the theme of the question of the day, I have another question for you that I would like you to answer. Answer from the heart.
Okay.
Or from the soul. Just answer be truthful.
From the vagina. I don't know.
That might be it too.
I don't know where my thoughts come from.
What was your last moment of bliss?
Of bliss? I think Miami. I think my birthday.
You want to explain?
Because I was just, detail. We were, I think the last day we were in Miami, we were in a really, a beautiful room, like a really nice room. We could have gone out and done things and we were in Miami and we didn't do anything and we didn't feel like we had to do anything. We just stayed in the room and relaxed. We had a little sex. We had some food. We watched TV. We didn't feel pressure to do anything. We didn't have anybody calling us. Like, I liked not having an agenda for a day.
Damn it. I was going to try to catch you out there, man.
What?
Nah, because Keanu Reeves, he was asked the same question. What was his last moment of bliss? And he was talking about, he said that it was a couple of days ago with his honey. First of all, that's the oldest shit ever.
He old.
His honey.
Keanu's old.
Yeah, I didn't know how
old he was.
He's
fine, but he old.
Yeah, yeah. And he was saying that it was a whole bunch of them just smiling and giggling and just talking the whole day. And I was like, man, that sounds so nice. I bet Kristen would never answer like that.
That's literally what it was.
You motherfucker.
Yo, you have no, like, you don't.
No
you
faith. Don't,
no faith at all. What about you? What was your last moment of bliss?
I mean, it don't matter now. It was Miami.
It was Miami too? Yeah. Oh, we was both blissful. See?
Yeah, the night before. We chilled.
That's right. We know what happened the night before.
And if you don't, go to Patreon right now.
Oh boy.
Yo, so you have to walk me through this whole thing with Tyrese and his girlfriend or ex-girlfriend. I'm not sure which one it is.
It's his girlfriend.
It's his girlfriend.
It's his current girlfriend. There was a clip that went out. I guess they were on Instagram Live or something. And she was talking about how she wasn't into him. He wasn't her type. She wasn't into him. She was into his boy. Because she was like, you know, with your age. And he just thought she had a nice smile. She was just like, oh, he had a nice smile. And that's cool and whatever.
She but thought she he was too old. Boy. I heard that.
Now, what I do want to say is that we had a clip that went out from an older episode where I told, I said you weren't my type.
Right.
When we first met.
Right.
And you weren't. Right.
You don't ask me right like I had
no,
the answer
I'm saying,
to you.
But we discussed it. But I didn't think there's not a problem with that. I don't think there's like you don't. That's not why we're together. I didn't say you were ugly. I didn't say. I just said you weren't the typical type that I go for. I think everyone was kind of mad because first.
She said his boy.
His boy. Specific name. Specific name.
The boy that's dead.
Is you said it very harsh. That's wild. Yeah, the one that's no longer living.
Right.
And I don't even think she had met him. I think it was like, yo, I just think his boy was more her type. Why are you bringing up his friend that is no longer living? That's literally, that is his friend. You could compare, even if for one, don't compare me to nobody specific, but also it's going to be somebody I literally know.
Yeah, that's wild. That's wild. Like, you know.
And that's no longer living and you know I have feelings about, like, that's my boy.
It
like,
ain't even him about
because
no
why
longer
bring
living.
Him up? Why bring him
it's
up?
It's the fact that it's my boy. Like, I have never been some friend groups I'm in. Mm-hmm. I'm the cutest one. I know it's me. And then some friend groups, I'm like, you know, I fall somewhere in there. You know what I mean?
I'm in the numbers. I'm on the page. I don't know where in the
you
book
know what
I'm
mean?
At.
It just depends on what friend group yeah. I'm a part of. And if I was a part of that one friend group where I know I'm not the one, mm-hmm. and you tell me that one of them was your type,
yeah.
I can't bring them around you no more.
It just seems more like it was specifically this person. It was like, because of your age, and I just wouldn't go for that or whatever. And now she did mention something about how he didn't, I guess she's an Instagram model, and he didn't understand how that worked and would talk down to her and stuff, mm-hmm. but it like... Everything about it seemed so negative to the point that I was even watching it. Like, why are y'all together? Like, I don't understand. And he started getting a little like, went too far.
The when she said it, his whole face changed.
He was like, nah, this went too far. We got to get off this live. Yeah. And he didn't even look like he was joking. He was like, nah, that's a little too much. And she was like, you know that. Like, you know that the whole conversation about not being my type.
No, I didn't know that.
I mean, you know now. That whole conversation was a real conversation. But as far as saying like, yo, this person specifically, or she almost made it seem like he was ugly though.
Well,
not
she,
being your type and being
no,
attractive
she said,
is
she
two
said,
different things.
It's not that you were ugly. She did say that. But to me, once again, it's going back to you thinking about, you feeling my boy,
yeah.
fam.
Yeah.
Like you thought that was the one that you was going to holler at. It reminds me of that old interlude with.
Oh, yeah. You brought that up.
The Mace interlude where he's on the phone. He's like, what's up, girl? Da 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 da. And she's like, the real nigga I wanted was Puffy, but he didn't come to the club that night, fool. I bet that wreck you really mad. That's what I heard.
Yo, you know every inch of every Mace album.
You right.
You know
right.
every inch.
Yeah.
Wait, how many albums did Mace have? Two?
He has three, actually.
Three?
Yeah.
It's three.
No.
It's two.
It's Harlem World and Double Up. And when Welcome Back came out, I don't think he put a whole album out.
Oh, okay. Yeah, but you know every inch of them. That's crazy. That is the first thing that you said when he said it. But
yeah, like...
Yeah, don't put a picture in my head of what it, exactly the type of... Especially if somebody alive, I know.
If he was alive, would you have tried to holler at him?
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Like, because I know they haven't been dating that long.
Yeah, I don't think she was around when he was alive.
Right.
He was married. And well, I don't even know if he was married when... But yeah, so...
Yeah, it that's wild.
That's crazy.
That is wild. Mm. Something else is wild. I read this and I don't know if it was a joke or not, but it was on Twitter. They were saying, fellas, is this gay? Is it gay to have sex with a woman?
At this time? Why? It says, face sitting cowgirl in any other position with the woman on top are fundamentally acts of homosexuality.
Stop right there. I don't even understand how that works. Like face sitting, I love when a woman sits on my face.
This is hilarious. Like, I just hate people. It says the male, by being in a sexually submissive position, is engaging in homosexual activity, and conversely, the woman being in a dominant position is engaging in lesbianics. Lesbianics.
Now here's the.
Oh, it sounds like lesbianist.
You can't now. Here's the dumb part about here. Sexually submissive position is engaged in homosexual activity. That's saying that both males that are having sex are both being submissive, which isn't usually the case. Like there's usually a dom and a submiss.
You said both males that are having sex.
Yeah, are usually being submissive. Are both being submissive, and usually there's a dominant and there's a submissive person when anybody's having sex.
Uh-huh.
So the fact that you're saying that sexually submissive position is engaging in homosexual activity, that's dumb.
Yeah, I think that's
stupid.
I think regardless, like, I don't... That's... So the question of is it gay to have sex with women was more sarcasm than anything. That was the quote that... Because somebody put this up. I want to know who posted the original post about saying all of this stuff. Because I just don't understand why.
Why is it so important?
People think that anything other than you having sex with a person of the same sex is gay.
Wait, say that again?
Anything other? I mean, you are gay if you're attracted and have sex with someone of the same sex or bi or whatever. Then you're, you know what I mean. But like, you're still a man having sex with a woman. How is that? I don't understand how that's gay.
Oh, okay. I get what you're saying.
I don't understand why y'all think that's... Like, why y'all don't understand terms no more? Like, why is... I don't understand. Are you enjoying yourself having sex with a woman? Even to me, even pegging. Like, if it's a woman pegging, that's not gay. You still having sex with a woman. I don't understand. All of this stuff is very confusing to me on why y'all want to put so much pressure on people that are living their own lives. Leave them the fuck alone.
This is very true.
It's so stupid.
This is very true. I think, like you said, I think who you're having the sex with determines if it's homosexual, if it's heterosexual.
You just like the way you said it better?
No, I'm just saying, I was going to continue. Okay. I think that there are, different things that you could do inside of that sex that, don't determine your sexuality. But it can be looked at in a way where you're like, do you want to venture off?
I don't understand that. That doesn't make any sense to me. Like you said it like it was plain as day, but
that's where the question will come in.
I know, but why are y'all worried about what the fuck someone else
is
doing?
This is true too.
And during their sex and what they enjoy. Those are things that they like doing with whoever their respective partner is. But if it is two people of the opposite sex, regardless of what is happening in there, it's not gay. What are you talking about?
Well, not me.
No, I'm saying...
Oh, I didn't like the way you looked at me when you said that.
No, you said... I'm not talking about nothing. I'm just saying what they said. But it's so dumb. Like, why are y'all so worried about people? And if... Goddamn. Even if they are gay, just let them do... What if they're gay and they're doing what you would consider heterosexual positions? Like... You know what I mean?
No. Because I think you could do any position.
I think you could do any position with any partner. That's what I think. That's what I think. But I don't understand. I've never understood why people why it affects somebody else, or why are you going to be like, well, what are you doing in your bedroom? Are you doing this? That's gay. You gay.
Yeah, like, you, it shouldn't matter what somebody else is doing in their bedroom unless they're like us and we tell y'all.
Yeah. And also, it shouldn't matter to you regardless. You know what I mean? Whatever.
So, did you see...
Yep.
I didn't even get it out. Mm-hmm. Did you see the guy that left his girlfriend because Chris Brown gave his girlfriend a lap dance?
I think that is some punk-ass shit. Mm. Like, first of all, why are you not excited that he just went ahead and gave her the experience that you paid for?
Excited?
Not excited. But, like, you left her because she got on stage? He does this every concert, and she's the one that got picked? So, she left to go home with you, right?
Okay. Let's say you go and get a lap dance in public from a guy or girl, whatever.
Because we can, even if we took this off Chris Brown, this also, there was also a video of Usher that was going around the internet, mm-hmm. of him coming up to this lady in the crowd, and like, he was singing to her, and he fed her a strawberry. She fed him a strawberry. And then she fed him a strawberry, and he was like all on this lady.
Now here's
all, like, I mean,
I'm gonna get there. I think that it just depends on your actions when you're getting said lap dance or whatever the case may be.
It's part of, if it's part of the show, like, yeah, you know, they're not gonna do show. They not going, that's,
don't be the show.
They want you to get excited.
Now I want you to get excited.
And I watched this clip. She just looked regular excited.
No, she did. And the dude that left, he was a punk ass nigga, man.
Looked regular excited. Like, I'm on stage, right. I'm getting a lap dance. I came here for this concert, now I'm in the concert.
Don't go try to grab his dick. Don't do that.
Okay.
Don't try to lick the sweat off his chest.
Okay.
Don't get fed strawberries. All right. With your tongue all out.
But wait a minute. No, because it's different. Listen, he just fed her a strawberry, and he said, now feed me.
Nah,
and
I can't do that.
She picked it up and fed
That's
him the strawberry.
That's when you passed me the strawberry, like, you hungry,
first of all,
my nigga?
Nick.
You know what I'm saying? I got you, B.
No,
here you go.
So you were telling me that if we go to the Usher concert,
concert.
I'm still planning on doing. And he come up to me and he say, feed me. I'm going to say no in front of all those people.
Nah, you're going
to
say, hold on, and give me the strawberry. And I'm like, you ready?
Usher said, feed him. Usher's hungry.
Exactly. I'm like, you going to give me the strawberry? Usher, I'm like, you ready?
But Usher's hungry. He needs the sustenance to continue on with the show.
And I will help him.
So now I'm responsible for keeping the show going. Or what you going
to
do?
I'm going to hold the strawberry up like, you want it fed or you want me to give this to you?
You gonna say that to Usher?
Why not?
You gonna ruin the whole show for Usher.
Is that gonna ruin the show?
Yeah, because now he got an attitude. You think he can do all the moves so you don't have to call with an attitude? It's take a lot of energy. You just took the energy out of this nigga.
Fuck,
he still
that.
Got
not getting fed
he
no
still
strawberry.
Got a less part. He still gotta do that.
You're not getting fed no strawberry. And even if you are getting fed a strawberry.
But he's hungry. Usher's hungry.
Oh, feeding.
Usher's hungry now.
You gotta do it full handed though. Like, you gotta put your whole hand in his face when you give him the strawberry.
So you want me to touch his whole face?
See,
if I feed him the strawberry,
that's why your ass ain't going to
Usher.
But
if I feed him the strawberry,
you ain't going to see Usher.
I don't have to touch him.
You ain't not
he
going to Usher.
He just bites
Usher
the
land.
Strawberry. He doesn't even touch my hands.
Nah, son.
And what if he say that's okay because he still got on the woman, like, dance with her a little bit? You gonna tell me I can't dance with Usher? You know how many dancers want to dance with Usher?
You can two-step with Usher.
But, like, what if I always wanted to be a background dancer and this was my moment to just do
I've
a
seen
little...
your dances, no.
You haven't seen my real ones.
And Usher's going to be able to see them before me?
Baby,
the world's going to be able to see them before me?
It's on a big stage. What if I get a job? I thought we was concerned about keeping our family together. What do you mean?
Listen, man. I think there's insecurities... Mm-hmm. And then there's having some decorum when you're out with your man or just out in public, period.
Yeah.
And I think depending on the venue or depending on the situation, depends on the type of decorum that should be had.
Now, I do agree with you. But I also think that as entertainers, we have to remember that they are there to put on a show and give and give fantasy.
I'm not mad at that man.
And give fantasy. I think social media and all this stuff has kind of thwarted that image. Like, we kind of forgot about that they're there to entertain and not there.
Listen, I want it's him not to real entertain. Life
unless. Usher seems like one of those niggas. It's like, yo, can you go get that girl? I was dancing. He seems like one of those. He seems like he absolutely does that.
Listen, if I'm being honest, I might want him to give you a lap dance real quick because you ain't fucking him tonight, but you gonna fuck me tonight and you gonna think about that lap dance. And if you gotta think about another dude while you fucking me, but the pussy still gonna be good, hey, keep thinking, baby.
Nah, I don't think that's why you would want him to give me a lap dance. I think your business now would be like, our views gonna go up. Make sure you wear a podcast shirt when we go to the Usher concert, because as soon as they see and then we have sex,
they're gonna wonder what that is.
What is that? You go out there, you put on the best show of your life. You hear me? Matter of fact, when he done, throw out a sign that says, and then we have sex on it. Yes, Usher, tongue my wife down. You hear me? No? There'll be a topic. See, you know how we look for topics for the podcast? What if we part of the topics?
Fuck you.
Ooh, and ain't nobody ever been part of the topics they got a podcast, right?
No, that's not true.
Okay, well, I still want to go. I do. I put this in here.
You put this in here. Go ahead.
I think this is passed already, but it says adult film star King Nasir is currently in Ghana to satisfy. Is it Ghanaian?
I think it's Guyanian.
I don't think that's right. Guys, I don't want to say this. Guys, I don't want to say this wrong because I don't want, you know, if you fuck up something, people feel like you being disrespectful. And I don't want to, but from Ghana.
It might be Ghanaian.
It's an actress from Ghana. And y'all might know a little bit more about this than me. But
what's her name?
I can't say her name.
Sugar Titi.
It looks like that. So I'm just going to say that's what it is because I don't want to fuck it up. And I don't want y'all to get me for fucking it up.
She cute.
But I put, no, she cute. So this adult film star is currently in Ghana to satisfy her because she publicly declared that no man allowed her to reach orgasm. And then it says they will compete on a live paid platform.
Where the fuck is this platform?
I don't know if this happens already, but the fact that for one it said compete. And I think he has a U.S. Navy shirt.
Yeah, I think that's just for...
I know. I don't think he's in the Navy, but I think he's from the U.S. I don't really know him.
I've seen a couple of his videos.
You have?
Yeah.
He been in some of them videos that you be watching?
Yeah.
You watch a lot of Spanish girls.
I switch it up every couple of months.
Do you? I'm telling you, I think you want me to be Jennifer Lopez so bad. But the fact that they will compete live on a paid platform to see if this man can make her, I think that is crazy and also genius. Mm. First of all, that's a great way to get a random porn star to fuck you. That's a dream, right? A porn star to fuck you?
Is it a dream?
It's like, ha, I bet you can't do it. And then he shows up.
It's a dream.
He show up and then it's like, psh. And now we got to compete? Like, you have to do your best moves. Like, the best
to make her come
ever done in your life.
See, that's the problem, man. It's like, he's probably going to be fucking forever to try to make her come. Because I think that it's so much harder for a woman to reach orgasm than a man. It's so much harder, especially if you've never done it before.
It's a lot of different points, yeah.
Yeah, so she can't even guide you.
And we've talked about the difference between coming and orgasm. It's a different thing. But
yeah,
now
she can't even guide you to how to make her orgasm because she's never had one before.
That's hilarious.
But here's the funny part. She says that no man.
Yeah.
So maybe she came from a woman.
Maybe. Yeah, they don't say all that. But I mean, I think it's a great way to get fucked. I think it's a great, it's a very smart way to be like, I bet you can't do it, and then get paid money to compete and see.
I'd do that for somebody.
And I wonder how long it is that he has to try, because it's got to be timed. It can't be like a 24-hour thing.
I don't think it's gonna be timed.
Can't be like a 24. It got to be like within this time something has to happen.
Hell no.
Really? You don't think so?
Hell no. Nah, within the sexual section. The sexual session.
Session. Okay. Well, yeah. That's great. Okay. Well,
speaking of porn stars.
I salute her. What?
Speaking of porn stars. Now.
I didn't know you was going to say this.
we think that everyone who supports us.
That's why you got your backwards cap on and shit today. I'm surprised you ain't wear your Tim's.
My Tim's right over
your
there.
Your Tim's right over there. They in eye view, so you can be inspired about this announcement. Go ahead.
We think that each and every person who supports us are equal in our eyes. And we thank you guys for being on this journey with us for as long as you have been. A couple of days ago, I was scrolling through our Instagram and I seen somebody come up and I didn't know the name. So I'm not, and it's not creepy, I hope. But a lot of times when new people come up, I just tag them, just get a mental vision of who the person is.
I like remembering who follows
us. Yeah, exactly. Because you never know, you might see them in a live again, or you might actually see them out in public. So I like to just have mental visions of who the people are that are hitting the follow button. So I went to the page and I was like, AKA. I said, wait a minute.
Oh.
What's that name again?
That's a legend.
A fucking legend followed us, guys.
VHS legend.
What?
When there was only, hold on, I gotta tell you, somebody said something about, I was gonna find it, but, so go ahead and say the name.
Mr. Motherfucking Marcus followed our little old podcast.
So, I put it on Facebook, and there were people under there that were like, I know who he is, and there were people like, I don't know who he is, and then, this one lady was like, I really don't know who it is. Like, educate me. And then this other lady said, well, gather around, kids. Decades ago, when there was nothing but VHS tapes, sometimes you would pop one in and you would see his cap and his Tim's. Like, it was just, like, it was a little fairy tale. That shit hilarious, but shout out to that. That's crazy.
Yeah, man. So appreciate, I don't know if he listens to the podcast as well, but, you know, if you are a porn star that might know Mr. Marcus and you listen to the podcast, then we appreciate you as well. Yeah. But let them know we appreciate that.
That's crazy.
Yeah.
That's crazy.
Yeah, man. Let's get into things that have nothing to do with sex. You put this in here. I don't know why, but
Eva, Marcel and her husband are divorcing after 5 years of marriage.
Mm-hmm. Now I've seen that he said he's gonna fight for his marriage.
That was the thing that I think I wanted to bring up, is he kept talking about he was gonna fight for it. She filed for divorce. Not sure. It just says it's irretrievably broken. So I don't know what happened. But I have a feeling about when people are like, I'm going to fight for my marriage. Because we were just talking about divorce. Like, when people get a divorce and it's like, it's probably painful, but it took a lot for you to get to that point that you wanted to do that.
Mm-hmm.
But, like, if it doesn't make you happy, and if there was nothing, hopefully, that you tried to do before that that made it better, I don't know if I want you to fight for me. Unless I specifically was like, yo, like, if I was trying to get you to fight for me before I filed, and you didn't do it, like, I don't know if I want you to fight for me after it's filed already. Like, I feel like we've done everything we could do. And I'm just assuming, I mean, I don't know the relationship. I know they have kids. But, like, if we've done everything that we can do and nothing has worked, and now I'm doing this, and now you realize I'm serious, like, I don't know if I want you to fight for me. I think I want us to just be amicable. Like, I don't know if I want to be in that situation again. If it's going to make us better, if it's going to make me happier, I don't want you to put me in a situation that's not going to make me happy.
So, I think that the times that I ever fought for a relationship, it was selfish.
Yeah.
Sometimes I would get the person back. Sometimes I didn't. But I think in all times it was selfish, and it was me thinking about what I wanted and not thinking about what they wanted.
Yeah, that's the point. Yeah, yeah. Like, I want you to make sure that it's good for both of y'all, but she's the one that filed. Like I said, I'm assuming that most people, when they get to divorce, it's like, we have tried everything.
Everything, yeah.
And nothing has worked. Like, yeah.
Or maybe they didn't. Yeah. Maybe they didn't try anything.
Yeah.
You know, and maybe he's like, yo, we didn't give this a chance. We didn't give this a go.
Yeah.
I'm going to fight for this, you know. Or it might have been a thing of where, you know, like you said, maybe she did want him to fight for it.
When it says,
and he thought he was.
When it says irretrievably broken, that's like, oh no, there's nothing that's saving this.
That sounds like he cheated, but you know.
Yeah, I don't want to assume nothing. I don't know anything, but that's just my thoughts on it. Like, I don't, if it's not going to make me happy, please don't force me to be in something that I don't want to be in.
Yeah.
I don't know.
But what about if I know what's best for you?
Okay.
Okay. Brain scans have shown that Botox injected into the forehead alter people's brain chemistry, impacting how they interpret other people's emotions. Fucking duh.
It says,
and I'm still getting it.
This may mean they find it harder to interpret other people's emotions because of disrupted signaling between their facial muscles and their brain.
Mm.
The facial feedback hypothesis states that when we see an angry or happy expression on other people's faces, we flex or contract the muscles in our own face in order to simulate the expression. I'm sorry. I'm not laughing. This is an unconscious process as our facial muscles mimic other people's smile or scowl. Signals are sent to our brains to help us interpret them.
And that's why I said duh. Because it's like, if you can't make certain motions,
people don't know how you feel.
No, you don't know how you feel.
Oh, yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
It's not funny, but also,
but I'm still doing it. I'm still doing it.
Why? You don't need it.
Yet.
You have really good skin, actually.
I do, but you know, there are problem parts. There are problem areas.
Yeah.
That I want to fix.
But it's, yeah. I mean, you got like a little bit of, you don't really have crow's feet. It's just under your eyes like me.
Yeah, and I want to get this, I want to plump this up a little bit.
Why? That's plump.
No, like.
No, that's not what I meant. That's not how I said it. Wait, let me say it again.
I don't know. Fuck you.
Wait,
you said it.
Wait, you gotta.
I don't like the way you said it.
People on audio don't know what I'm talking about.
I don't like the way you said
it. You're talking about his smile lines, but it's not that it's plump. It's not. It's not.
You said I had high cheekbones the other day.
They are high.
And now you're saying it's plump.
No, I'm saying they high, but they cushioned. You know what I mean? They're not cushioned.
That's worse than plump.
I don't know what to say here.
Don't say shit.
All right.
Let me get my Botox in peace. All right.
You get whatever. I don't know how to do this. I think I'm dead. I'm done with that. No.
You want to touch this?
Nope.
Why not?
I'll touch it later when I get more details. I'll get more details.
What more details do you need?
I want facts to come out. I just want all the details before I say anything.
Oh my gosh, there's nothing else that's going to come out.
Yes, there is.
No, there isn't. I'm telling you right now.
Well, maybe I didn't read all the stuff, but I know I don't want to get into it. I don't. I'll get into it. I'll get into it next podcast. I know it's still going to be a topic.
No, it won't.
Yes, it will.
I don't think you understand what kind of money is behind this guy.
Nah, I will get into it. I just, yeah.
She be scared,
I'm
y'all.
Not scared. I like knowing what I, things like that, I just want to know what's going on. And I think once his name came up on my timeline and I saw it and I read the first article, I was like, okay, I don't feel like, They're like, oh, we're gathering information and da da da, mm-hmm. And I was like, all right, well, I'm just gonna wait, like,
but
because it was all over the timeline anyway, and I was like, let me wait until they gather information because.
But once you recant, what information are you gathering?
There's a lot. There's a lot that goes into that. There's a lot that could go into that. Like, I don't know. I don't know. I didn't read enough about the rest of it, so I just I don't want to comment on it until I know. You always want to
be scared.
I'm not scared.
Philadelphia is set to pay pregnant women $1,000 per month.
You shitting me.
You're not getting pregnant again.
You are shitting me. This not nigga going to get a vasectomy and they paying?
In Philadelphia.
We would have moved to Philly.
No, we wasn't.
What do you have, twins? I wonder if they give you more money.
That's a good question.
That right?
Philadelphia officials announced Monday they are fundraising to launch a trial program to give $1,000 monthly cash payments to expectant mothers who live in certain communities.
$1,000 a month is great.
Yeah. Yeah. I wonder if that's going to take away from other programs, though, like WIC.
Mm-hmm. So it says, infant mortality in Philadelphia is a solvable crisis. We know that being able to better support pregnant people and new parents helps keep the babies alive. Yeah, as the poorest big city in the country, this is not always easy, especially in areas of the city that are being crushed by generational poverty and systemic racism.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I completely understand that. No, That's actually a great move. That's great.
I just, you know, anytime these money things come up, in the back of my mind, I'm always wondering,
yeah,
what does that really mean for a person?
Yeah. Yeah, what's the science behind it?
Yeah, exactly. Like, what is, how did y'all figure out all of a sudden you want to just give this money?
Yeah, no, you know, I get it.
What's being taken away from?
Isn't it terrible that we always feel like there's another agenda when somebody tries to do something good?
Well, that just feels like that's what,
look what they've done to us, though.
Yeah. What are we watching?
The Voice. We are watching The Voice.
This is The Voice.
We are still watching The Voice. Yeah. Y'all know we fuck with The Voice, yo. He got a whole team.
My team is strong, too.
I think some people here take off his team, but he don't want to listen to me. He didn't even watch all of the playoffs. Was it the playoffs?
Listen, everybody.
Or the battle rounds. He didn't watch all the battle rounds.
I didn't watch one battle round because I was sick.
Yeah, so he didn't.
But I was listening.
He didn't see everything. But yeah, I still got, the people I'm rooting for. I'm ready for these playoffs. I still love Chance as a judge. Chance and Callie are my favorite judges. I mean, I love Blake, but he's leaving. But Chance and Callie, I love them.
I like Chance as a judge after he did the, I think it was with the girls, the three singing girls and the other girl.
A sister.
Yeah, and he did the arrangement.
You didn't watch that.
I listened.
Oh, I didn't know. You was so drugged up.
Yeah, exactly. But my ears were working.
It was so good.
It was.
He did a really good job. I really like Chance, though. I already had faith he would do a good job. He's a producer. I've heard him flip shit before. Like, he's great.
No.
And Kelly is Kelly. I mean, I don't care what y'all say. Kelly, a legend. Kelly is a legend. Actually, I said, I don't care what y'all say. Ain't nobody ever said nothing about Kelly. Ain't nobody said nothing about Kelly, but the fact that she be killing them covers in the muumuus. Them little muumuu dresses?
Yo.
Killing the covers. They probably expensive as hell, too.
What, the muumuu dresses?
Them little paisley dresses she be wearing.
Oh, yeah. $1,200 easy.
She just be flat-footed, just killing niggas. Like, on every kills every color cover. I'd be mad if Kelly Clarkson covered my song. I would be mad if she covered my song or her karaoke shit and I had to go back out into the world and sing it. Kind of like that. I watched Kelly Clarkson, a part of her interview with Angie Martinez on Angie's podcast, the In Real Life podcast, which is great. But it made me love her even more. Like, how you look for something. Like, it seemed like too cool of a person or nice of a person or normal of a person, and it made me love her more. She's so smart. She's been in this business. You forget because she's so...
She's been in the game for years.
All right. She's so nice, and she's so, like, she has that kid, like, I don't know, the sense of humor and stuff. Like you forget she's been in... The first American Idol?
Yeah.
Like, that's crazy. Like, she's been around so long, and she still seems so humble and down to earth and just, I love Kelly Clarkson.
No, definitely, definitely. So...
You watch this.
I was trying to go to sleep a couple of nights ago, and I just couldn't get it through it. My foot was throbbing. So I turned on this damn show on MTV. It's a regular-ass MTV show, but it had me so intrigued. And they put the commercials at the right fucking places.
You love mess.
Oh, my gosh. Help, I'm in a secret relationship.
I didn't even know people still watch shows on MTV.
I was shocked that it was on MTV. I was like, this is what Netflix does now.
Which
threw me off. I was like, wow, Netflix really stole MTV's DNA and brought it to their damn platform.
It's better.
Yeah, it is better.
It's better.
Because you can cuss.
Yeah.
But yeah, man. So I'm watching this show, and it's two people in a relationship, and one has a secret. Like, they keep them away from family and friends and all that just because they're hiding something. And it's up to these two people to come in and help them bring out whatever they're hiding. And boy, it was interesting as fuck. Man, I didn't expect it to go the way it went.
It's almost like Cheaters. Like, that's what it looked like when I looked at it.
Yeah, but it wasn't, though. Like, it had a little bit more heart to it. A little bit more heart to it. Like, the host of the show, and I forgot their names, but they actually seemed like they gave a fuck. You know what I mean? Like, it wasn't just, oh, we're just doing the show. We trying to find some mess out.
Yeah, I ain't watched the Peter Guns reboot, but I can just guarantee that nigga did not give a fuck. You hear me? I'm pretty sure. I'm pretty positive that he didn't give a shit. I saw one clip of him fighting one of the niggas. I was like, oh, why do y'all have him there? What is he doing?
He's starting the shit.
Yeah, he's supposed to be breaking it up.
Shit, in one episode, they actually had Peter Guns check on Peter Guns.
Yeah, it was me. He showed up and it was like, it's a mirror. What? It's me? I'm the problem. He walked into a room. We need to bring you into a room. And it was like just a room full of mirrors, like a dance studio. And he was like, so where are they? And it was like, you looking at them. You looking at the culprit.
I am the cheetah.
It is me. And then he had to talk himself down. You don't have to do this, Peter Guns. You love this woman. You don't have
fight
to do
that,
it.
Peter Guns.
It's just him and a camera crew in there with a wall full of mirrors. Yeah, that's yo, that's crazy. I would pay money to watch that every week. I would pay-per-view that.
Oh shit.
They should put that on Zeus.
Seen the first, I watched the first episode of Succession, one of my favorite fucking shows. I'm so sad that it's ending. Great way to start it off. Like, I'm intrigued already. It started slow, but they always start slow on Succession, so I'm not even worried about that. But I love the way the story is set up. In full transparency, last season wasn't my favorite season out of any of the seasons. Mm-hmm. This season already seems like it's going to be better than that season.
Because it's the last one.
Not always, though. Yeah. Not always, man. Yeah. But yeah, so I'm really excited to see where they take the show and how they ended. They all doing their thing, though. I love it. Kieran Culkin. I always say his name is
Kieran.
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 Kieran Culkin, man. That's my dude.
Yeah. Kieran.
I can't wait to see what he does next, man.
Yeah, man.
It's like we lost Macaulay and we got him.
We didn't lose Macaulay. Macaulay's still out here. He just had a baby not too long ago.
Yeah, but he don't act no more, so we lost him.
And I don't think he needs to act anymore. He's like Mariah Carey for Christmas.
He is.
Right? Every time that, man, he
they
don't have
the
to
king
do nothing.
Queens of Christmas.
You know, that's Mariah Carey. She could drop albums. That'd be cool, but she don't have to.
Wow.
Macaulay Culkin is the Mariah Carey of Christmas.
That's crazy.
Yeah, he's the movie Mariah Carey.
That's crazy.
And he started that off early.
And check it.
Early.
Check it.
No, you didn't just check it. Are we on Crush Groove?
No, ready?
What is this? Is this Beat Street?
MC.
Oh!
Whoa. 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 It was written.
Wow.
That's crazy.
Wow.
Yeah. Yeah.
Oh, that's crazy.
Yo, insight.
Oh, we could almost end it here for real. That's a closer. Nobody ever knew that.
Never knew.
Oh, shit. I'm ready to celebrate Christmas. I'm about to put Macaulay Culkin at the top of the tree. I'm about to put him and Mariah,
right
at the
there.
Top of the tree.
Yes.
Wow.
Yes.
Ooh, C is like Claus. No? It don't do the same thing, huh? C, they both last names end with C. Claus, Santa.
Mr. Christ.
Claus. All right. We've done enough.
All right.
All right. You done?
All right, let's go.
Wow, that was crazy.
I watched Power Book 2 Ghost, first episode. Pretty fucking good. But I love that show. And I don't know exactly why I love that show. I'm not saying it's the best show ever or nothing like that, but it's just something about it that just keeps me there each week, man.
Yeah.
SWV Escape. Now, I told Kristen I did not want to watch this goddamn show.
We didn't
show.
Talk about this last week?
We didn't talk about it last week.
He didn't want to watch the show because he was like, I don't want to watch women fighting. Like, I don't like watching that. And then I had it planned. This is what I do with most shows.
We did talk about this last week.
We did.
Yeah.
Well, this is what I do with most shows. I just want y'all to know. He'll tell me he don't want to watch a show. And then I just turn it on and walk away. And sometimes he sit down. And that's how I get him to watch shows. I'm about to get him to watch a lot of shows because he can't walk that far right now. So I'm going to turn on New Girl. I don't know if he know that, but I'm going to have New Girl just playing.
Oh, I got to finish
The Good Place.
I'm like, it's one episode left.
You got to finish The Good Place.
And I've been savoring it.
Yeah. Yeah, and I haven't watched, I think the last episode was with...
You got to say the actual show today.
Oh, the SWV and Escape show.
Oh, okay.
The last episode, and I don't think we talked about this one last week. I think it came on after that, was the one where Candy wanted them to headline.
Yeah.
And Coco was like, no. They was like, we can co-headline. And Candy was like, I want it bigger. And then I saw somebody on Twitter say something that made so much sense.
What's that?
Candy and Tiny are bringing, they have a bigger audience, but they're bringing the audience based off their headlines, and SWV is bringing an audience based off their music.
True.
Not taking anything away from Escape, because you know I fucking love Escape and SWV. I fuck mm-hmm. with both of them, but I.
Who do you think they? So they were supposed to be co-headliners that, and I think that gets lost.
And I love, and I like I said, I love both. I love Candy. I love Coco. Coco live out here, don't she?
I don't think she lives out here, but she's like
out she has here. A house out here.
I don't think she lives out here.
She like, has a house
I think
in Virginia
she goes
Beach.
To sleep out here every day,
but she has a house in Virginia Beach.
You just gonna tell her where people?
They said it on the thing.
Oh, all right. I follow one of her best friends. Didn't even know it, man.
I mean, all of SWV, but specifically Coco is yeah. like she be out here a lot.
I think SWV should close the show though.
I can understand that. I think they were just looking at billing. And right. I personally would want to go, like, I would still be inclined to go to an Escape and SWV. Like, same,
or an SWV and Escape. Like, I wouldn't
yeah,
care.
I would be inclined to go if their names were the same size.
Right. But I think that because SWV songs are, they have bigger hits, mm-hmm. I think they should close this show. Mm-hmm. And I think that's, and that's the other reason why I think Escape should open the show, because they have more songs that people know.
And they have well, no, I think they both equally have songs that people know.
Nah, I think SWV, they have hits.
Yeah.
But you don't really know the B-sides.
Most people do, baby.
Who know the B-sides of
a
SWV?
A lot of people do. SWV songs are very, like,
you know the B-sides?
Yes.
Name one.
That see, now you said that to me, and it's
okay. Name an Escape,
but it
B-side.
Doesn't matter. Even if it's not a
name an Escape.
No,
B-side.
You said it because now their songs are meshing in my head together. Because I love both of them so much.
I think more people know B-sides from Escape than they do from SWV. But I think that SWV have bigger hits.
But
that
SWV
would close out.
But SWV
fucking
has more hits though. That's
no,
the
no,
thing.
I'm not, they so have, it wouldn't yeah, have, that as well.
So the thing is, they wouldn't need to do B-sides. They wouldn't have to, because no, there are so many hits.
I get that, but SWV, I mean, Escape, that's why I think Escape should go first, because mm-hmm. they can, you know, they can give a bulk of that time, and then when SWV come out, it's like, bam, dun, 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 and they just
but
rock.
I can understand why Escape would go last, because if you're bringing your audience from
with?
TV, I'm saying if you're bringing your audience from TV,
that's who they want to see,
then it would be like, that's the headliner. I understand the thought process behind yeah. it. And to be honest, in my head, they would end with both of the groups singing Weak.
Both of the groups singing Weak?
Yeah. I think that's a song that both of the groups can sing. Everybody knows it. It's probably the biggest hit out of all of them. I think they could end like that. That,
as long as Coco get to do Coco.
Oh, who? What?
I don't want nobody else doing.
I don't think Coco's gonna let anybody else do Coco.
I don't want nobody else doing nothing.
I don't think Coco's gonna let anybody else do Coco. Okay. But I mean, first of all the women are amazing.
Oh yeah, yeah, like, yeah. That goes without
all
saying.
All the members, like, they can all whatever. But I don't think it would take anything away for them to have the same billing, because at the end of the day, you're going to see two of the greatest, some of the greatest girl groups of all time.
Yeah.
On stage together. Like, I don't know. I mean, it's money in it, and I get all that, but like, I just feel like this shouldn't even be a conversation, because yeah. you coming in, you like, if you see
now, what the conversation is the money. Where the money at?
No, I mean, I get it, but
Tasha. Where the money at?
Tamika just released a video on YouTube or some shit like that, where she exposed everything. And I was glued.
You see, this is why I don't like watching these shows. You get me into this goddamn
mess. I was
mess.
Glued to the video. You didn't have to go to YouTube for that. That was on Twitter.
I know, mess.
I'm glued. You hear me? But okay, I gotta keep watching.
Go to your other messy
all
show.
Of this has kept me together. Don't do that. Love is Blind, first of all, you should have been watching it, because that's all my timeline was talking about.
I don't watch Love is Blind until they actually are together.
Yeah, but you've never seen the beginning to say you wouldn't like it. That's
I don't
what
want
I'm saying.
To.
It, you know why? So hopefully y'all watched it, but if not, spoiler alert, because I'm probably gonna give some things away. No, I won't. I don't think I'm gonna give the matches away just yet. I don't think. But there is one girl that there's two girls that a lot of people don't like, but I'm talking about everybody was watching Love is Blind. And there's one girl who gets with one of her matches and like fights another girl for him, basically. And he picks her And they get outside and she is not fucking with this nigga. Like, he was like, can I get a kiss? And she was like, let's just hold that for later. Like, on some shit like that. Like, not. And then the whole time there, it's these two girls. They talking shit about everybody. It's this dude, Kwame, that everybody's been talking about, who was a black dude that.
I mean, you said Kwame. I wasn't thinking a white guy.
I know, but. One of the first things that he said, he was like one of the first people that everybody was talking about, because he came in and he said he wanted to use the name Alex because when he says Kwame, that puts him in a specific category and it turns people off. And I'm like, what the fuck did you say?
Yeah, that's
I ain't, it's like, that. Oh, because we know you black and now you just, what do you mean? You don't want anyone to judge you because you black? Like, I understand what he's saying, like, this is about Love is Blind and da-da-da, but, like, at the end of the day, I'm going to come out, I'm going to be black. Like, that's your name. But everybody was talking about that. A couple of people was like, what the fuck did you say, Kwame? Like, it's a girl, Irina, and it's a girl, Micah, that a lot of people ain't not really fucking with. But there is this one couple, this one black couple that is, like, I love them so much. They are I think it's Brett and Tiffany, and they are, like, the example that we have been wanting to see on Love is Blind for a while. I mean, we had Lauren and Cam, like, we had them, but, like, this is this beautiful black couple that has gotten together. He's like a Nike designer. Like, they're just, I don't know. I'm rooting for them, but it's very interesting. At first I didn't think I was gonna like it because I like all the other seasons of Love is Blind, but they done already started with the bullshit. So I'm like in it. I'm like in it, and the new episode come out on Friday, but that's all my timeline I've been talking about. I think I looked at Mouse Jones had tweeted something about, this is why I didn't want to stop it, because I knew I was going to get drawn into this shit, and that's all he was tweeting about one day. And I was like, see, this shit is crazy. But so yeah,
listen to the question, man. What do you guys think about people in open marriages? I'm not married, but I know a guy that's in an open marriage, and I'm on the fence about talking to him.
We had somebody send something like this to us before that was similar, that was talking to someone that was in an open marriage, I think. But I mean, I think that is an agreement that they have in their marriage, and I don't give advice. Y'all know this. And I like to say that a lot because I want people to understand that don't do nothing that I'm not telling you. Don't listen to me. But that's a decision they made in their marriage, but you didn't make that decision. You know what I mean? Like,
so go fuck, girl.
Wait, you just gonna scream? Our babies are outside the door this time. They just
got
home.
You're right.
But like, they made that decision and they're comfortable in their marriage. But like, this is a decision you got to make by yourself because you the lone one on the outside. You know what I mean? So
just remember, as you're fucking him, that
it's okay.
No, I mean, it's okay. But at some point, she might become like Monique. And decide that she doesn't, the wife might decide that she doesn't want to do an open marriage anymore. Yeah. And you might get used to the dick.
But everybody's not like that. There are people that have been in these relationships for years. I looked at, and this isn't, I guess this isn't open. Because open, I believe, is when you know, and date other people outside of it, but y'all not all connected. And, but this, this woman is polygamous, I guess, when they're married to them. Mm-hmm. This woman was married to her first husband for 26 years, and she has a second husband that she's been married to for 10 years. So they all live in the same house together, and these are both of her husbands. Mm-hmm. But what's so interesting about the dynamic is that she's looking for, like, she's dating. She's still dating. And the one that's been there the less amount of years is like
the least.
You want to start correcting me on words.
No, I was just
saying. The one that's been there for 10 years is like, you know, she just started doing this and, you know, I'm okay with it. But like, I can't say that there won't be jealousy if she starts falling in love with another man. Cause I can't, like, I don't know if I can share her heart with anyone else. And I was like, but y'all all live, like, I can't understand that. They all live in the same house and she's dating other men outside of that. And he's like, I don't know if I can share her heart. I can't take her. I can't give her.
I mean, I guess after 10 years, you get used to sharing one person, but it's a whole new person that she's like, because it ain't nothing worse than like having an ex and they get into a new relationship and they so excited about this relationship. And,
I get that.
Oh my gosh, yeah, that shit hurt.
It,
oh.
It's like, we got a well-oiled machine. It's two niggas in here. You like, need another one?
We good. We got a dick schedule and everything.
Yeah, it's like you Tuesday, Wednesdays, you know, that's my shit.
Yeah. You know what I mean?
Now somebody come in on Saturday, Sundays, you don't know what
fuck
to do.
Fuck it up. Like,
yeah, I get it.
I thought we was both resting on Saturday and Sunday, but you not resting?
It was so funny. I saw that the interview though, and I was looking at the dude, from the husband that was there for 26 years, and he just looked like, I'm tired of her anyway. So I'm just glad there's somebody here to take the weight
off.
I'm just
doing this because she got good insurance.
Yeah, like, and they actually have 3 or 4 grown-up kids together. Wow. And they had the discussion with their kids beforehand. And it works for some people. But you specifically, going back to the letter, like, if it's not something you agree to, that's like a decision you gotta make. That ain't about what we think. It's just, you know, are you comfortable getting into that situation?
Yeah, man. So remember, when you hop on the dick,
okay,
you might not be able to hop off at your own term.
Yeah, you might fall in love if you haven't prepared yourself to be like, I could be in this.
And they might take away their open marriage situation.
Oh, or they could keep it. You might be in it now.
Bam.
That's a lot of things that can happen.
Yeah, I might be girl. Man, that would be dope. Like, you go,
all
on
right,
a date.
Here it is, and there he goes.
No, I'm
all
just
right.
saying, like, you go on a date with the husband, and then you come home with the husband and everything, and then you see her homegirl, and y'all go out to the club later that night and just be partying, like, oh my girl, don't you hate when he be doing this? Like, you know what I mean?
I mean, I guess it is good to have somebody to vent to.
Yeah.
And talk shit to, be like, I know it's not just me, right? You see it,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, man.
Like, I told this nigga, clean the grass. Clean I don't know grass. Why I said that. Clean the clothes. I don't know. Wash the clothes. What do you do with the clothes? I told this nigga, wash the clothes. And he left it there for 3 days. Girl, I know. I seen him for 3 days. They just been sitting there.
Yeah, man. So I hope that helps. Probably doesn't.
It probably doesn't.
Yeah.
I don't give advice.
Anything else you want to touch on before we get out of here?
No, just please buy your tickets as soon as possible for these shows. The tickets are going fast. Like I said, Dallas VIP is already sold out. Also tonight, March 30th, I am headlining at the Virginia Beach Funny Bone. There's still some tickets left for that. The next show we do is April 13th at Stardome in Alabama. Please get your tickets for that. We have our Philly tickets for the added show go on sale Friday, and Chicago, the added show tickets are already on sale. What else am I thinking? I know there's more stuff, but get your tickets as soon as possible. Yeah, Dallas VIP is sold out. Atlanta, one of the shows I know is already halfway sold out, and that's in July. So just get those tickets.
Put your make sure you're subscribed on all of the platforms that we're on. Keep your notifications on, though. Yeah. That's super important, especially on social media, because like we told y'all before, they be trying to play us, you know, dirty. And until I buy this badge.
He is really going to buy this badge.
I'm going to buy the badge.
He want, like, respect, y'all.
I don't want y'all to think that, you know, when I buy the badge that we got that, like, organically. Nah, I bought it.
We've
you
been trying to get a badge on Instagram, and they keep rejecting us, saying,
yeah, so I'm gonna buy this shit.
Whatever.
I get it.
He just want respect, y'all. Yeah,
that's all.
Respect,
no clout. Yeah. No, this ain't about clout.
Now respect me.
I just want to make sure that y'all see our shit first.
Respect me. You need one on Facebook too, because you have almost 500,000 followers.
I know.
Facebook.
They should be giving me that for free.
None of those people are following me on Facebook, by the way.
I'm sorry.
It's fine. Don't worry about it. And I think
you know the fucked up part about that, though?
What?
They know who you are.
They was like,
they be typing your name and everything.
I like her through clips and podcasts. I don't want to know nothing else about her. And that's fine. That's all right.
Oh,
and that's
man.
Why I don't post that much on Instagram, because who gonna see it?
Mm.
You know, it's cool. And I think that is it. Don't forget to, like, leave reviews. We're so glad when y'all share the videos on Instagram, because it brings people to the podcast. Catch up on the podcast. Follow me on Twitter, Kristen Sivills on Twitter. And I think that's it.
Yeah, we 5 episodes away from 200, man.
Yeah, and I think we're gonna take a break. We don't have to take a break. I don't know what we're gonna do, guys. It's fine. I just gonna wanna make sure I wanna do this.
Oh man, yes. But we'll keep y'all in the loop with all that we do. But right now it's time for us to leave. So with that being said,
wait, join the Patreon. Okay, bye. Go. Join the Patreon.
With that being said, and then we had sex, and so should you. Thanks for listening.
Let's start over. Topic. Words. All right, go.
With that being said, and then we had sex, and so should you. Thanks for listening.